maximum of deck, up to 3 inches or 76 millimeters thick, providing protection against aerial bombs. And the ends of the box were formed by transverse armored bulkheads, 2.5 inches or 63 millimeters thick. Each weighing 112 pounds or 51 kilograms, and the bags of cordite needed to propel them. Each turret was manned by a crew of 27, and a further 20 worked in the shell rooms and magazines below. The turret crew loosened both the shells and all cordite charges manually into the breaches of the guns. The guns were then trained and elevated by hydraulic power. The firing sequence was controlled from the director control tower under the overall command of the captain and gunnery officer. A well-trained crew could be expected to fire up to 8 miles a minute from each gun. HMS Belfast guns are now silent, but both forward turrets are trained on a target 12 and a half miles away on the other side of London, the Scratchwood motorway services area on the N1. As a reminder of the immense power and range of these guns. The main turret, the forwardmost of HMS Belfast's 4 6-inch gun turrets. Each of the heavily armored turrets houses 3 6-inch guns and weighs 175 tons. These guns, which helped to destroy the Scharnhorst and which battered enemy positions in Normandy and Korea, are an impressive reminder of the awesome power of naval gunnery. HMS Belfast 6-inch guns could be used either against surface targets or to bombard enemy positions on land up to 14 and a half miles or 23 kilometers away. The 4 6-inch gun turrets were controlled from either one of the 2 armored director control towers. The director control towers were responsible for detecting and identifying potential targets for the guns. From 1942 onwards, targets were acquired and tracked by radar, but before that, large optical range finders had been used. Information about the target's range and bearing was then passed to the transmitting station. The transmitting station housed the Admiralty Fire Control Table, a mechanical computer which calculated the correct elevation and training needed for the gun's target.
Thank you.
known as the deflection correction, which anticipated the likely position of the target at the moment of impact, based upon observed changes in the target's course and speed immediately before firing. Other factors taken into account by the fire control table included outside air temperature and barometric pressure, wind speed and direction, and the number of rounds fired, all of which could significantly affect the accuracy of the guns at long range. Once the steam had passed through the turbines, it was cooled and allowed to collect as water.
Ben daha var.